This photo, provided by the Kansas State Historical Society, shows Charles Curtis, the only Topekan to serve as Vice President of the United States with the man he served under, President Herbert Hoover. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy for CJ Online, talking about Curtis, who was born 160 years ago next Saturday, on January 25th, 1860. I'm standing beside a statue of Curtis located in front of 820 South Kansas Avenue in downtown Topeka. Curtis served in the U.S. House of Representatives from 1893 to 1907 and in the U.S. Senate from 1907 to 1929. He was elected Vice President of the United States in November 1928 and remains today as the only Vice President to have had significant Native American ancestry. After a term plagued by economic depression, Hoover and Curtis lost their bid for re-election in November 1932. Curtis then died in 1936 at age 76. He's buried in Topeka Cemetery beside his wife Anna, shown with him in this photo. While he was vice president, Curtis's official address continued to be this stately mansion at 1101 Southwest Topeka Boulevard, where he began living in 1907. This photo shows the interior of that home, which was purchased in 1993 by Don and Nova Cottrell. They did considerable work to restore the building and turn it into the Charles Curtis Home Museum. Don Cottrell died last month, 23 days short of what would have been the couple's 70th wedding anniversary. The museum is currently closed because Nova Cottrell has been ill, though she hopes to reopen it in the spring. This is Tim Rencher, the history guy for CJ Online.